Hi guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to show you how you can add a metallic look to anything. So if you are ready for this tutorial, let's jump right into this. So to begin, what I want to do is that I want to only turn the red areas of this Tesla into a goldish color. So the first thing that we need to do is, first of all, make a selection of all the red areas. So I'm going to use my quick select tool to make it easier for me. I'm going to make sure my layer is selected. Click on select subject. Now Photoshop is going to make a selection around the entire car, but we don't want the whole car to have the metallic look. We want to make sure the windows don't have that gold effect on it. So I'm going to cut out those areas. Now you can wait to cut those out after you have applied the gold effect on the entire thing, or you can take it out. But I want to crop it before we move forward. So I'm going to take my lasso tool and I'm going to make sure my subtract from selection is activated. I'm going to zoom in, and the easiest one we're going to do is the top. So I'm just going to just trim this area. It's going to take a bit of work, so you need to have patience when taking out the other areas. We also want to make sure that we cut out the light. So with our subtract tool still activated, we are going to trim around the light so we can take that out as well. So we have the light on this side out. We are going to do the same thing for this area. I'm going to zoom and do the same thing for this light. So for the rest of the stuff, I'm going to fast forward so that you can see the end. So now that I have the car cut out, I'm also going to add this little metal trim. Now, this is all preference. You can choose to even add the car bumper, but I chose to take that out. I'm going to go ahead to add the rims. So I'm just going to fast forward and see you at the end. And now, what we're going to do is also subtract the black areas on the inside. So, as you can see, this is a lot of work. And this is just optional. If you want to do that, you can do it. But you can choose not to add the inside as well. So if you zoom out, this is what you have. I'm going to cut out the other piece as well. But before I do that, I'm going to make a copy of this. And we are going to apply the layer mask effect. I'm going to turn off this layer. And I'm going to add a background. So I just clicked on the plus to add a new layer. And I'm just going to add a black background so we can see. So you can see that these are the cutouts that we have so far. I am going to turn off the actual image so we can cut out the other one. So I just pulled it on top and I am going to zoom in and I'm going to use my lasso tool. We're going to make a selection around this. And then when we finish, we are going to add it to our layer max that we just created. So now that we have our selection, we are going to go to our layer max. And then what we are going to do is pick our brush. And if your brush head is not showing, all you need to do is turn on your caps lock and it should show you your brush head. So I'm going to make sure my foreground is. So as you can see, if you turn on your caps, the brush head goes, but if you turn it off, you see your brush head. So that's how I've included my rim. So I'm going to press Control D to deselect. So now that we have our selection made, if I turn off the original image, you see that everything that we want to turn gold is what we have cut out. So what I'm going to do now, I want to make a copy of this and put it on a new layer. So I'm going to turn back on the original image, add a new layer, and I'm going to press Control, holding it down. I'm going to make a selection of my layer max. So you see that it picks up all the areas that we've cut out. I'm going to click on the original image and I'm going to press Control C to make a copy. And I'm going to click on my new layer and then I'm going to paste. And I'm going to turn off my layer max since I don't need it anymore. I'll bring it below. So to change the color of the skin, now that we have extracted that from our original image, what we want to do now is to make a duplicate of our skin. So I'm going to just drag my layer to my plus icon. It will create a duplicate for me. And with the duplicate layer selected, I'm going to go to image adjustment and I'm going to turn that to black and white. And I'm going to click OK. I'm going to make a duplicate of this layer. And I'm going to change the first one to difference. And then I'm going to go to image, adjustments, and invert. So we have this chrome effect. And I'm going to now merge. I'm going to now merge my difference layer effect with the regular black and white image we created. I'm going to repeat the same process again. I'm going to create a duplicate and then I'm going to change the top one to difference and then go to image adjustment and I'm going to change that. Click on invert and I'm going to merge these two layers. So this gives us a very chrome silverish effect. Now, the next thing we want to do is to give this look the appearance of gold. So what we want to do is to apply gradient map effect. So you do that by right-clicking on your adjustment and then you choose gradient map. Now, when you choose the gradient map, you see that it gives you a gradient effect. You double click on that, and then you want to make sure that you have a three-tone gradient effect. Now, if you don't have that, you can go to the presets and choose it, or you can manually create that. So I'm going to show you how I created my gold effect. So first of all, we want to have three stops instead of two. So I'm going to hold down my Alt, and I'm going to split the stop so I get three. And now I'm going to leave it right there. Now I'm going to double click on the first one and I want to change the color and I'm going to choose a default setting that I've already set. It's 2D1203. That's for the first one. And then I'm going to click OK. Now we're going to change the middle one. We're going to change the middle one. Middle one is activated. We're going to click on the color and we're going to change that to C07E00. So that gives us the goldish color we want. I'm going to click OK. We also want to change the stop color to a lighter gold. So I'm going to change that to F7E4A3. So this is all preference. So if you like these settings, you can write them down and use them as you practice. So I'm going to click OK. And now, yes, obviously, the goldish color has been applied to both the car and also the background. So what we can do is to click on, we want to click OK first. So we are out of the gradient. And now you want to click on this little icon, which will apply the effect only to the layer beneath. So now you can see that the gradient map has been clipped only to the layer below. I'm going to collapse this property. Oh, by the way, if you don't see your property displayed, you just have to go to Windows, and in your Windows, you'll be able to find properties. The other way you can also clip is hold down your Alt. You see that a little activation icon has been generated next to your mouse. If you click on that, it will only apply your effect to only the layer beneath. So now we have this goldish. I love it. We have this goldish effect. And see how even the mirror reflection is shown also in the glass. So now that we have this, we're going to turn off the skin layer that we originally had, since we are not going to use that. You can even delete that. And I'm going to turn on the original image. So if I turn on the original image, then again, this is preference. You can actually cut out the entire car and get rid of the background and replace it. But I just wanted to keep the background and just show you how you can apply this goldish effect. So this is a very nice effect that you can add to any image. It can even be your logo. You can basically turn anything to have a metallic look. And that is just a concept that I'm trying to convey here. So if you have an image that has a lot of texture, you would want to soften the texture a little. And that is where you can apply different filter effects to help you smoothen out and have a very nice. So to do that, we want to select both the gradient map, the scan. We're going to right click and we are going to convert to smart object. So let's say you use an object that has a lot of texture and you want to smoothen it out. In this case, with the car, we already have a smooth surface that, you know, we are working with. So you really don't need to do a lot of changes. But in case you have a very textured surface that you're working with and you want to smoothen it out, you want to go to filter, blur, surface blur, and this is where you can smoothen out your texture. So if I take, you see, if I move, you see there's a little bit of a shadow around this area of my car. Now if I move my threshold a little bit, and you see that I begin to sort of lose that a little, and it makes it a little bit more soft. But this is all preference. If I don't want this harsh area, I can take the threshold a little bit further and it's going to smoothen it out for me. So this is all based on how you want your finished item to look like. I'm going to move it back a little because I like the natural effect that it gives me. So I'm just going to click OK. So the next thing we want to add to finish it off is, so we want to go to filter and then choose filter gallery. You want to apply the artistic plastic wrap effect. You want to take your detail all the way to 1 and then your smoothness to 15, your highlight to 20. You want to click OK. So it gives you this effect, but that's not where it ends. So you want to click on your filter gallery icon next to it, and you want to change the blend mode to dodge, And we are now going to take down the opacity so that we get a little bit of a sheen to the car instead of the muted version that we had. And then you click OK. So you have this goldish car. And if I disable this filter, you see the before. And if I enable it, you see the after. So it's a slightly different punch, which it adds to your color. And like I said, you can increase it or you can decrease it depending on the intensity that you want. So there you have it, folks. This is very simple, but I wanted to take my time to show you how you can apply a goldish effect to anything or any object. So I hope you found this tutorial very helpful. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell for all future uploads. And as always, thanks for watching. I've noticed that a lot of people like the different flyers that I'm doing. So what I'm intending to do is to put out one flyer design either once a week or every 2 weeks. I will upload a flyer design in case you want it. I know there are others on my channel that are following me specifically for that, and there are others that are following me for other things as well. So I want to make sure that I'm satisfying both of my followers. So have a blessed day, and I will see you in my next tutorial. Bye.